Hey guys, namaste, this is Alex, and if you haven't already subscribed, then please do. Welcome to the first vlog of Vlogmas. Well, that's really weird to say on the 5th of December, but that is what this video is about, how to keep up with Vlogmas. But now let's roll the Christmas sequence.
Wish you a Merry Christmas, we wish you a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year.
So would you guys really believe me if I said that I've been trying to vlog since the past 5 days? Because I really did, and these are some of the clips that you can see. I have all the footage from the past 5 days, but I just couldn't be able to publish those because I felt like there was something missing in them. But that's when, as a YouTuber, we struggle with ourselves, right? Like the quantity over the quality, so we just keep ourselves from not uploading those. So that should be the number one thing, that is quality over quantity. So what would you choose as a YouTuber? The thing with the Vlogmas is you need to have quality as well as quantity at the same time, which really burns you out as a YouTuber because you need to put out the content daily, so you don't know what to do, what to put it out, what are the ideas that you need for the Vlogmas, and all the XYZ excuses that can come up to your mind. You need to keep those excuses aside, because think for a moment, you have been waiting for the entire year to do a Vlogmas, and then when it's exactly the time that you need to motivate yourself and put the content out, you're not doing it. Then what's the point of waiting all those 11 months just to get up on the 12th? Second tip is how not to get yourself burnt. It's completely understandable when you're trying to maintain your corporate life, your family life, also you're trying to document yourself, put out content, taking content, consuming it, all that is really burning you out, and at the end of all of that you will be like, I just don't want to do it, maybe I just won't rest today. But I would ask you, why not? Look at me, I just had that one trigger with me today. It's like about 4 and I would never record a vlog when the daylight is gone. But if you would believe me on this, then there is a cyclone Ochi crossing right next to us, but here I am recording a video in this much devastated weather. It's been pouring down since yesterday night, it's still raining. I'm not sure if you guys can hear it or not, it's still raining, there's no light. I have increased the ISO so you guys feel like there is some daylight coming in, but trust me, it's not. The whole damn weather is nice for a hot chocolate milk and just stare out of the window. But that's not applicable unless and until you put out the content out today, Alex. The third point is losing subscribers in your Vlogmas. That's completely understandable and it's not your mistake. Look, no one has ever complained about losing their subscribers just because they are putting out content every day. But I would highly suggest you to do this Vlogmas, because the things that will turn out after about 7 to 10 days of doing vlog is absolutely amazing. Because as far as I understand the YouTube algorithm, if you're putting out the content daily, then there is a high end of percentage that you would reach to an extended number of audience than you would if you're putting out the weekly content. It's not YouTube mistake, and you can't even judge your videos at this moment because it's haven't been even past 5 days. But seriously, trust me, don't stress yourself thinking about the subscribers at this moment. Since I saw that yellow demonetization and all the things that's happening around YouTube, it's just really stressing. That's when I thought to myself that, Alex, would you still be doing YouTube if you had no monetization and got no subscribers? Which brings us to our point number 4. Be passionate about your storytelling. Look, as we just talked about getting burnt with all the content that we are putting out on a daily basis, but you need to re-engineer your mind and get to a point where you feel like, this is what I'm doing for myself. I'm not doing it for the subscribers, I'm not doing for anything else. I just want to document my life, my passion, and I want to share some story. I want to share and have that relationship with my audience. Even forget about the audience at this point. Just enjoy yourself in whatever you're doing. The only thing that you want to do is just have the camera on record when you're doing your thing, and all the lights and decorations that you see around, how can you sit and say, I'm not able to do it? Fifth and a final tip is get yourself scheduled. Now we all know that we all stop recording at a point where the clock hits 5. Why? Because it's winter and the daylight is already so low. So here are some tips that I want to give you guys to make yourself prepared ahead mentally as well to record a video every day. How do you do that? You know that you have to wake up early, so make sure you're charging your batteries at night. When you're awake, make sure you just have your camera ready for that amazing moment to start your vlog. And once you're done with the vlog in the evening, have some relaxed time with you, then just transfer your footage and start editing. Then you know that you need to have a thumbnail, put it out, edit, cut it, paste it, and just throw that intro sequence there, end screen there, just put it to upload and hit that publish button. Don't wait out for that aha moment to go and publish. That's gonna ruin your vlogmas. Even if your quality wasn't so good, but if you had a story, then I suggest you to put it out. And if you don't have anything else to do, tomorrow we will be back with some amazing vlogmas ideas. So if you're thinking that your life isn't really that interesting, that you need to watch this video, make sure you subscribe. Just few days of December and then we are off to 2018. So don't miss out on this amazing year that we had so far. Just give it a go. I'll see you guys in the next video. Until then, adios, amigos.